Welcome to tutorial number 2 of the Freeplayer 3 Music Playout software. In this tutorial, I'll explain the Live Assist function and the mixing of your music files within Freeplayer. Freeplayer works great as a Live Assist automation system for your playlist. You can play out files from the main playlist in the on-air players and make smooth segues with the audio files. Let's load a sample playlist to show you how this works. Here we have a playlist loaded into the main playlist area. We now can set some mix points for these files to make great segues from one song to the next. To do this, just drop a file from the main playlist into the editor mixer window. As you can see, as soon as the file is dropped into the editor mixer, it begins to play in the yellow section. At the same time, the next item from the playlist is loaded into the green section of the editor mixer window. Most features here can be done with just your mouse. The set mix is where you can set a mix point on the audio file in yellow by using your mouse to drag the green audio file to a specific point it will begin playing during playout. To drag the green file, do a right mouse click anywhere over the yellow wave file. Then move the green audio file to where you want it to begin playing as the audio file in yellow nears its end. Fade out is where you can set a non-destructible fade at the end of an audio file as the next audio file begins to play. To do this, play the first file by double-clicking on the yellow wave. Then set the fade out point over the yellow area with a right mouse button double-click. When you set a fade out, the audio will fade from the point where the bright green line is until the fade out line, which is the blue line. Offset is where you can skip past a portion of the audio at the start of a file. For example, if there's silence at the beginning of the wave file, or the song has a low or ramp-up intro. This way, your segues will sound great. To use the offset feature, just click on the green file so that it will begin to play. Then set offset, shown as the red line, with a single right click at the point you want the file to start. Once the offset is marked, click the Use Offset button. This will reload the audio shown in the green at the offset point. Now, the file will start at this point when it plays from the playlist. Again, this is a non-destructible edit, so it will not affect the original audio file. Once you have set the mix point, fade out or offset for the audio file, just click below the yellow wave or above the green wave to stop the audio. Up next is the zoom feature. This function can be used to listen to either 10, 20, or 30 seconds of the beginning and end of each audio file. The default setting is 20 seconds. Using Zoom, you can adjust this to meet your preference. If you want to display the complete wave and listen to the complete audio file, click on the Zoom button to toggle Zoom off. For now, let's set Zoom to 20 seconds and make some real changes into the playlist we have loaded. Now, I'm going to set all files in the playlist to make some smooth mix points. When you're done, click Save, followed by the Next button to load the next item from the playlist into the Editor Mixer window.
Hey, you!
Now that mix points have been set in the current main playlist, you'll notice they are all saved as part of the playlist. Notice the offset, intro and mix columns. The mix is set on all files now, and the second file also has the intro set at 7 seconds. Now it's time to play out the playlist on air. First, I'll let the computer do the job by putting Freeplayer in automatic mode. Now the playlist will be played out according to the mix settings we just made. When Freeplayer is in automatic mode, the Jingle 1 and Jingle 2 players cannot be used. It will blink and will also display a lock icon next to the player number. The main playlist will use Player 1 and Player 2 for segues in automatic mode. However, the other players can still be used to insert quick drops on demand. Press the play button in either Player 1 or 2 to start the playout from the main playlist. Notice how the audio file starts to play. Since Freeplayer is in automatic mode, you can see when the next file will start to play. For this file, it starts on the last 4 seconds of the audio file. You can also see this in the digital clock window. The yellow timer will count down to the next mix in Freeplayer. Let's skip to the end to see how this works. Let's do this for some more files so that you can see it will play out the playlist exactly as we made the settings in the mixer editor. That's all for this tutorial. I hope this helps you understand the basic playout feature of Freeplayer. If you need more information or have questions, please visit the Freeplayer forum at www.verdonschot.eu. Again, that's www.verdonschot.eu. Thanks for watching this tutorial on Freeplayer 3.